The step back three has become one of the most lethal moves in the NBA.
Irving and Curry, one-on-one. Irving puts it up. It's good! Kyrie Irving from downtown!
Used for game winners.
Steph for the lead.
He got it!
Or to shatter a franchise's morale for years to come.
Lillard, long-range three, and it's good!
Step back three has become almost unguardable. But in the modern NBA, one player has rejuvenated the art of the step back jumper, and that is James Harden.
Another one for James Harden.
And so far, Sixers up 10. Harden, step back, and the foul!
For Boston, Harden, step back three-pointer. That's good. James Harden from downtown.
James Harden is no doubt one of the most prolific scorers in NBA history. But how did this bearded man perfect the art of the step back three? And did he actually change the game of basketball? Upon James Harden's arrival in Houston in 2012, through a trade that remains heavily debated in NBA history, the Rockets underwent a remarkable shift, becoming a consistent contender. Prior to the era led by Harden, no basketball team had ventured to shoot beyond 35% of their shots as three-point attempts. Harden's individual performance is undeniable. He's a 10-time All-Star, a 7-time All-NBA, a 3-time scoring champ, and an MVP. Despite drama here and there, let's not forget he's a bona fide star. Harden has made the step back three-pointer his signature move. But how did this move become so good? Harden's approach involves his physical attributes. His sturdy build, measuring 6 feet 5 inches and 220 pounds at the time, long wingspan, and exceptional ball handling skills to create space by stepping back and launching the shot over defenders. Some argue that this is a travel, and I'm not going to get into it, but according to the NBA rulebook, it is not because of the definition of a gather. Do you think Harden's step back is a travel? Let me know in the comments what you think. Harden's trajectory transformed when Mike D'Antoni took over as the Rockets head coach in the 2016-17 season and positioned him as a point guard. This shift was historical, as he stands as the sole player in NBA history to average at least 10 three-point attempts and 8 assists per game in a single season. Harden's impact on his teammates is twofold. He generates shot opportunities for them as a point guard while simultaneously creating space similar to a shooting guard. In the 2016-17 season, the Rockets achieved an offensive rating of 114.7, marking the 10th best in NBA history, despite Harden being their sole all-star. Then in the 2019 season, Harden embarked on an iconic scoring streak, achieving at least 30 points in 32 consecutive games, the second longest streak in NBA history, trailing only Wilt Chamberlain's 65-game streak during the 1961-62 season. On a side note, do you think prime Harden and his Rockets would have beaten the Warriors if not for injuries? Besides the obvious LeBron's Cavs, I believe this Rockets team gave the Warriors the best matchup. Let me know what you think. Mike D'Antoni compared Harden's signature step back three to Kareem Abdul-Jabbar's skyhook, a shot that everyone might try but few could master. I don't know if that's disrespectful to Kareem, but hey, this shot by Harden did go on an absolute tear during his Rockets era. It also helped to have the other four players on the court be able to shoot threes. During that era, all the Rockets did was ISO with Harden and have everyone else on the floor shoot threes. If you've ever played NBA 2K, you know how difficult and cheesy it is to defend against this. Where do you rank James Harden in the greatest shooting guards in NBA history? I got Jordan, Kobe, Wade, and then maybe Harden. Let me know what you think. But this next cold-blooded player also has a step back as a go-to finisher, and that is Damian Lillard. Does anyone remember Lillard's game winner to eliminate the Thunder in 2019? Of course, we can't forget that, but I know Paul George remembers.
Lillard, a chance to send the Thunder home. Lillard, long range three, and it's good! At the buzzer, Damian Lillard, are you kidding me?
One of the greatest shots in NBA history, tied at 115 in Game 5, with the clock running down, Lillard took a 37-foot step-back three-pointer with Paul George in his face and sank it to send the Thunder home. The step-back, the wave, the crowd, everything was perfect. Not to mention the memes of Damian Lillard with his stone-cold face after hitting it. I remember watching this live and going crazy. That night, Lillard scored 50 points on 17 of 33 shooting, including 10 three-pointers. But let's observe Lillard's offensive formula a bit closer. Lillard's step-back jump shot appears incredibly smooth and natural. His offensive strategy places a greater emphasis on utilizing the jab step and the stutter step hesitation technique rather than strictly relying on traditional step-back maneuvers. By integrating these techniques, Lillard keeps his defenders uncertain and off balance, and making it challenging for them to anticipate his next move.
I got killed because I in the press, and I was emotional at the time. I got killed.
Yeah, that was,
in the media. Oh, he hating. Dame say, oh, he hating. It was a bad shot, but to his respect, like, he a hell of a shooter. And when that play is going on, like, I'm in front of him, And I'm like watching the time behind him and it's going down. So I'm like, when it like, at what point is he gonna make his move? Yeah. Like, and I see him sizing me up, like, so I'm like, I know this nigga's not about to shoot this shit from here. So that's why I jump before he jumps.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because it's like 2 seconds left at this point. Like, so he gonna, like, it's gonna be a tough shot if he like, so I jump before he jump. He ended up side to make the shot even tougher, bro. He sidestep it. And bro, the whole time I'm like,
when we talk about step back threes, we have to talk about the greatest shooter of all time, Steph Curry. Steph has transformed the once unlikely step back shot into a regular move.
Kawhi, Mad Steph Curry three. Got it, that was over James.
And 34 already as Steph is fouled shooting a three. Steph Curry, step back triple. Otto Porter has checked in.
Oh,
Steph open three.
Regardless of whether a defender is closely guarding him or not, he frequently employs a step-back jumper as part of his scoring arsenal. This maneuver has become so ingrained in his playing style that we often overlook the artistry and finesse with which he executes it. Curry's exceptional ball-handling abilities and deceptive moves compensate for any physical athleticism he may lack compared to other players. Especially in the years after Kevin Durant and when Klay Thompson went down, Curry leaned more into his scoring. We all love the Curry slide, and his step-back is a thing of beauty. Honorable mentions Kyrie's clutch step-back shot against the Warriors in the 2016 Finals.
Irving and Curry, one-on-one. Irving puts it up. It's good! Kyrie Irving from downtown!
And let's not forget Kemba Walker's iconic college step-back game winner.
Kemba Walker, step-back! Walker! Cardiac Kemba! Does it again! UConn wins at the buzzer!
Do you have a favorite step-back three play? Let me know in the comments and why.
I would love if you could leave a like on this video. Thank you for watching and have an amazing day.